students, welcome back to another session of Atoms and Molecules. So today we will see the topic formula unit mass. So how to calculate molecular mass or formula unit mass. So first of all, what is formula mass? So formula mass means it is the sum total of atomic masses of all the atoms present in a given formula. For example, if we will write water formula as H2O, okay. So how to represent the formula unit mass of water means as the sum total of 2 hydrogen and 1 oxygen's atomic mass. By totaling or by sum up the atomic masses of 1 oxygen and 2 hydrogen, what is the value we will get? That is called its formula unit mass or the molecular mass, okay. So hope you have understood this. So we know we required actually the things, the basic requirement is these values to calculate the formula unit mass, because this is the mass of each elements. Hydrogen, it is 1, we have already learned this table, but just recall it back. Oxygen 16, nitrogen it's 14, sulfur 32, then carbon 12, sodium 23, chlorine 35.5 and calcium 40. So let's begin this with the compound H2O first. So let's calculate the formula unit mass of H2O, 2 hydrogen and 1 oxygen. And we know the mass of 1 hydrogen atom is 1. And there are 2 hydrogens. So how we will calculate this? 2 into 1 plus oxygen's mass is 16. That is total it is 18U. So what is the formula unit mass of water? Which is 18U. Next, let's see the formula unit mass of ammonia, that is NH3, ammonia. So ammonia, 1 nitrogen and 3 hydrogen. So we'll calculate nitrogen's, we know its atomic mass is 14. Therefore 14 plus 3 hydrogen, so 3 into 1, which is equal to 17U. So what is the formula unit mass of ammonia? Which is 17U. Going to the next compound, third one, that is sulfur dioxide, SO2. Okay, let's see the formula unit mass of sulfur dioxide, SO2, which is sulfur which shows 32 atomic mass. Therefore, 32 plus oxygen, a single oxygen exhibit 16U. Okay, therefore 2 into 16, that means 32 plus 2 into 16 means even there also we will get 32. So what is the answer? 30 plus 30, 60, and 64U is the formula unit mass of SO2. Okay, so this is the pattern we will calculate the formula unit mass of different substance. Only the thing that we require, these values we should study and then apply it depends upon the formula that we will get. Let's see, move to one more compound. The fourth compound is NaCl, sodium chloride. Sodium atomic mass we know 23, and for chlorine it is 35.5. On adding what we will get, 23 plus 35.5, the answer is 58.5U. And the fifth compound, CH3OH. CH3OH means this compound is called methanol. We have to find its formula unit mass. So methanol means carbon. So one carbon's mass is 12 and 3 hydrogen, that is 3 into 1 plus oxygen, it is 16 plus 1 is hydrogen. So 12 plus 3 plus 16 plus 1, it is 17. That is we will get 15 plus 17. Okay, 15 plus 17. That is the answer is 15 plus 15, 30 and 2, 32 U is the answer. For CH3OH, its formula unit mass is 32 U. And next one, sixth one, let's write the formula unit mass of hydrochloric acid. Let's calculate the formula unit mass of hydrochloric acid or hydrogen chloride. So hydrogen, its mass is 1, so 1 plus 35.5. Chlorine atomic mass is 35.5, which equal to 36.5U. So this is the way we'll calculate the formula unit mass of different chemical compounds.
Now let's move to the other important concept, that is mall concept. Okay, so what is a mall? So mall concept was very, very important for us. And one mall, or what is mall means, it is the amount of substance in a molecule. Okay, so how much amount of a substance is present in a molecule, that is what called mall concept. Amount of substance, or amount of substance in a molecule or a particle. This concept was actually suggested by the scientist Amedeo Avogadro. The scientist's name is Avogadro. And according to this Avogadro, one mole is equal to, he has formulated a numerical value for this one mole of substance, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. So what is the value of one mole? One mole is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23. This value is called one mole. And this is commonly known as Avogadro number. Since this was suggested by Avogadro, this number is called Avogadro number, and which is denoted as N subscript A, capital A. Okay, so please remember, one mole means, mole means amount of substance in a molecule, and remember the numerical value of one mole. So generally we can say one thing, one mole of any substance, it can be atom, molecule or ion, whatever, it contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of molecules. One mole is equal to 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecules. Let's prove this using some examples. So let's take hydrogen. So what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? We will express it as 1 U. But when we will express it in terms of gram atomic mass, we can write it as 1 gram. Hydrogen's atomic mass can be expressed in gram as 1 gram. So 1 gram hydrogen atom. Okay, this is hydrogen atom. 1 gram hydrogen atom contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of atoms or number of particles. So remember children, hydrogen atom's mass is 1 gram. So it can be connected with the mole concept. 1 gram hydrogen atom is equal to, which contain 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. Let's consider the case of hydrogen molecule. It is H2. So when it hydrogen molecule means its atomic mass is 2U. 2 hydrogen comes. When it expressed in grams, it can be written as 2 gram. Okay, hydrogen molecule's mass is 2 gram. So 2 gram hydrogen molecule contains, okay, 2 gram hydrogen molecules contain 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of molecules. Previous case, hydrogen atom, there it contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of atoms, but here it's a molecule, therefore it changed 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of molecules. Okay, hydrogen H means it is atom, so H2 means it is molecule. So accordingly, we'll just add this atom and molecule also along with the 6.022. Okay, and let's consider one more example, that is water, H2O. So H2O, its molecular mass we know, we have already calculated, it is 18 gram. So 18 gram of water, one molecule of water's mass is 18 gram. So one molecule of water which contains 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of molecules. Okay, so 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 number of molecules. So from all these, we can generalize one thing. One mole is nothing but the molar mass or the molecular mass. One mole is equal to molar mass or the molecular mass. So students, this is the concept of mole. So please understand, one mole is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23, and which is equal to the molar mass or molecular mass of the given substance, depends on whether it is atoms, molecules or a compound. Thank you all.